Hey friends, I am at the Calgary International Airport at the Belgian Beer Cafe. If you've been watching this channel lately, you know I had a day where I was spending a bit of time here. So if you haven't seen those other videos, I had a 2-hour layover in Calgary on my way out to Seattle. And that 2-hour layover turned to a 3-hour layover. Thankfully, I found the Belgian Beer Cafe, did a couple beer reviews already. And I don't know if they just thought, you know, this guy just looks like he needs more beer or what it was. But thankfully, I got a couple samples, and I'm really thankful to my server, whose name I don't have yet. And if I get that later, I'll flash it up on the screen. So we've got a pretty decent on tap selection. Unfortunately, there's like 4 beers they are out of today. 2 of those are ones I really wanted to try, because I'm trying to try ones that I don't normally see locally for myself. What I went with, and I wanted Belgian beers, because that just feels right. So what I went with here for my 2 samples, these are not Banded Peak Brewing, that's just the branding on the glass. The first of these is the Rodenbach Classic. It's a Flanders Red, not a style I normally go for. Red brown, a sharp sour taste, fruity and refreshing with a balanced Madeira-like sweetness. Well, I won't be able to detect that note since I don't know what it is. This beer has been called a world classic in the Burgundy of Belgium. Wow, 5.2% alcohol. So if you can tell the color, yeah, it is quite red. It kind of just looks like your standard amber ale, to be honest. On the nose? Okay, so I get like a strong kind of a raisin note. It's definitely going to be a sour beer, for sure. Probably not going to be up my alley, but again, Flanders Red, not the kind of thing I normally go for, but I get a really strong raisin note on the nose. Yeah, all right. Let's go in for a sip. Cheers, friends. I really love putting malt vinegar on my fries. I don't necessarily like drinking malt vinegar. The Flanders Red to me is kind of like drinking malt vinegar. I mean, I'm not going to let this go to waste. But, yeah, I should know better than to order a Flanders Red. I wish I had a palate cleanser right now. All right, so the next one I ordered is the Chimay Blue. It's a Trappist Quadruple. It's 9% ABV. If I ordered a pint of this, it would cost me $14.50. Dark brown, unfiltered, powerful and complex bouquet of fine spices with a shade of caramel, becomes more complex with age. All right. Really curious about this. I've never had any beers from Chimay. I do see them in our local liquor marts in Winnipeg on occasion. I've yet to pick one up. So yeah, giving it a try today. It's a definite funkiness on the nose. And like an earthiness. I was at a beer tasting event a while back, and somebody said that there was like notes of, was it horse blanket? Which I thought sounded ridiculous at the time. I'm kind of getting a bit of that here. That made no sense to me when I first heard it, but it's the only thing that comes to mind right now as I smell this. And maybe, okay, so now as I keep smelling it, it just keeps becoming more complex. I get a little touch of like black licorice on the nose. There's a lot going on with this beer, and I'm sure that this tiny sample that I'm having doesn't do it true justice. The color on it, by the way, a little more of a brown than the last one was. It does say it's a dark brown and unfiltered. Kind of looks like a like a brown ale you would get in the British Isles. That's kind of what it looks like. Does not smell like that, though. All right, I'm going in for a sip here, friends. Cheers. Oh, that's interesting. I don't know if I've had a beer that quite tastes like that before. I do get a bit of caramel, which it said in the tasting notes. And there's just like... the taste lingers for a while with this one. And yeah, there's a lot of different stuff going on there. Yeah, you get a little bit of that caramel up front, and you get all kinds of stuff after that. Like, it says a bouquet of fine spices. I'd love to know kind of what spice might have been used in this, because there's some just really interesting flavors I've not had in a beer before. Interestingly, one other thing I'm getting out of it is a hint of bubble gum. So I get like the caramel up front, little bit of that bubble gum in the middle, and then just like this coating of spices. That is a really nice, really nice. I'm sorry. That is a really, really nice beer. It's really complex. There's a lot going on in this. I've never had a Chimay beer before. But as I said, I know I can find their stuff in Winnipeg. It always looks like it's a little expensive, and that's always been the one thing that's kept me from buying it. But I'm all in now. I got to try more of these. This is a fantastic beer, unlike anything I've had before. It is 9% alcohol. I mean, it doesn't necessarily taste boozy, but it does taste like a complex beer. So you wouldn't think that it would be like, say, under 7 or 6% or whatever. But yeah, no, this is a really, really interesting beer. I highly recommend it. The Rodenbach, it's just not for me, but if you're into Flanders Reds, you'd probably really like it. But yeah, I'm having a good time here at the Belgian Beer Cafe. There are worse ways to spend some layover time. All right, cheers, friends.